Hello, welcome back to my channel. How are you? I hope you're doing great. I am African Bella, the Real Talk, if you're new. I talk of relationships, fashion, beauty, and life experiences in general. So please subscribe to my channel. Today's video, guys, it is a story time. I know you always enjoy my stories, and I'm excited to tell you today's story. So friends, as some of you may know that, I am a Tanzanian, I'm from Africa. Some women in Africa, some, not all, accept to stay in a love triangle. A woman can date a man who has 3 or 4 girlfriends, and this man is dating them all at once. This situation is really bad. For me, I cannot accept that. It is very, very bad. But you find a woman proudly saying that, I know I am the chosen one, even if he dates all, but I am the wife to be. But how sure are you? Do you know his heart? No, of course no. You don't know his heart. So it is not good, and it is when you create a very toxic relationship for your future. Yes, he can marry you, but in the future he will do the worst thing because he knows you can tolerate a lot. And guys, there are some diseases. You should be careful. Please watch out. But here, I am not talking of the religion. I respect religion, guys. If the religion says a man should marry 4 wives, for me, I respect. But love triangle, guys, it is not good. But as you know, you cannot advise a woman who is blindly in love because love is blind. So let us start our story. Stay tuned, don't skip at all, and watch till the end. So guys, today's story is about a friend, but a colleague too. We are working together. This friend used to share with me her problems, her love struggles. We are not all that close, but she could feel free to tell me her stories, her problems. It has been always like that. People feel free to share with me their stories and their love problems, then I advise them. So we could do that with her. She had a boyfriend, and this boyfriend they met at the university when they were studying, and when they graduated, they continued their relationship. They really loved each other a lot. That everyone wish to be like them, you know, like the story of Romeo and Juliet. They really loved each other. And this friend of mine, the colleague, used to go at the boyfriend's house every weekend, starting from Friday evening to Monday morning. She could do all the house work, clean, wash his dresses, iron them, do all guys, cook for him. And she used to tell me that I am doing all this because I want to speed up the process. I want this man to marry me. I really love him so much. So I want him to notice that I am the wife material. So everyone at work used to joke about it and we could laugh. But guys, to be honest, every woman that was single, including me, wish to be like her, wish to have a relationship like the one she had with her boyfriend. So it was like that, you know. Sometimes you look at a couple and say, wow, they really love each other. This love is real. So it was like that, guys. So guys, the love story continued. They are very happy, and the boyfriend even made a surprise engagement party, guys. Yes, the boyfriend surprised her and engaged her. She was over the moon, guys. She was so happy, and we were all happy about her, guys. You know, it really feels so good when you see real love. Because out there in this world, much fake love. But this one, for us, it really looked so real. So guys, after the engagement, after 2 weeks, this man started avoiding the fiancé. Now she is the fiancé. He started avoiding her. When she calls to go to visit during the weekend, he says, no, I'm not around. I'm out of the city for work. When I come back, I'll tell you. And it reached a point my friend told me that, I don't know why my fiancé is avoiding me. He has never been like this. Why? I told her, no, you don't worry. Maybe he is really busy. Don't think negatively. Think positive, please. So she said, okay, I'll think positive. Maybe he's busy. Okay. So it continued like that. Then they started seeing each other again. And she told me, we are seeing each other, but the problem is he has changed. He's not the same man I met 4 years back. I don't know why. And she even told me, even the calls, sometimes he neglects, and even the messages, sometimes he does not answer. They've been fighting over small things with no reason. So she told me, I suspect he is cheating on me. I told her, no, why could you think of that? No, it cannot be. So so she told me that, you know what? I'll do something to find out. I told her, what? You wait, I'll tell you. So guys, do you know what she did? She had a friend who worked in a telephone company. She called this friend and asked her to print out all the telephone conversation and the messages of the boyfriend. So the friend did. She printed all and gave it to her. When she saw everything, it was true. The fiancé had another woman. This woman was still at the university. And he had even promised to marry her. And this girl was really in love with the fiancé of my friend. So she really got angry and she told me, I'll play a dirty game. They will know who I am. I told her, what are you going to do? She told me, calm down. I'm going to play smart. So she went to Facebook, searched for the name of that girl, and started chatting with her through Facebook. They chatted and she asked to be friends with her. She accepted. They chatted for a long time and they decided to exchange numbers. So she started asking, are you dating? Are you in a relationship? And the girl who was cheating on my friend's fiancé, said, yes, I have a boyfriend. The boyfriend lives in Dar es Salaam. And yes, sometimes I come to visit. And next week I'll be coming, next weekend, to visit him. Because sometimes I go, sometimes he comes. So I'll be coming. So my friend was like, so can we meet when you come to Dar es Salaam? She said, yes, we can meet, of course. So this girl, the other side, was really happy because she had met a friend through Facebook, but my friend was really angry about her, but she wanted to do something. So after she came and told me all about it, and I was like, so what do you want to do when she comes? She told me, I don't know, but I think when she comes, I'll go and fight with her. I told her, no, it won't help. You shouldn't fight. What I think you should do, you should tell her the truth that she is dating your fiancé. That will be better, but you should tell her in a good way. So she went and talked to her and told her everything, that, you know what? You are dating my boyfriend. My boyfriend's name is this, this, and this. He works at this place. And the other girl was shocked. She said, no, that is not true. He has promised to marry me. We have been in a relationship for so long. That is not true. She told her, it is true, and he has engaged me. I have the ring, everything. She could not believe, guys. She was shocked, but she could not believe. So she told my friend that, when I come to Dar es Salaam, please let us meet. So my friend told her that it's okay. You continue your relationship as normal. When you come, go and stay at your boyfriend's house, which is my fiancé, but go and stay and continue like normal. So what we will do, I want to come to meet you and my fiancé together so that we can talk and make a decision what to do. So she accepted and she came. She came to Dar es Salaam, and my friend called the boyfriend, like, want to go to visit for the weekend. The fiancé said, no, I'm very busy this week, don't come, I'm so busy with work. She said, okay, but she knew all again that he had a visitor, which was the other girl. So they stayed together, and I remember it was on Monday. It was a working day, and they had an agreement to meet for lunch with the other girl. The fiancé of my friend with the other girl were going for lunch. So during the lunchtime, my friend decided to go and meet them together. So she took the bus, and when she arrived at the bus stop, she called the boyfriend during the lunchtime. She was like, hello, how are you? I am fine, he said. Can we meet this afternoon? He was like, no, I am very busy. I am very, very busy this afternoon. I cannot meet you. Then she said, for this lunch. He said, no, I'm not even going for lunch. I am at work. Then she said, if you're at work, then I'm coming to your office. There is something I want us to discuss together. He said, no, I am not at office. I am at the other place working, but not at my office where I work. Then she was like, but me, I am almost at your office. Then he was like, no, don't go to my office, because there was the other girl, because she had come for lunch. So my friend went and she met them together, guys. The boyfriend was shocked. He did not know what to do. He was there like, he did not know what to do, guys. When he saw her, because he knew he was playing all those games without her knowing. But this time, she caught him. So she was like, who is this girl? Who is she? I was like, no, calm down, please, 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 my love, calm down. Don't call me my love. Who is this girl? I want to know. And the other girl was like, who is she? You know, but they agreed together that they are going to like meet that man together so that he can make a decision. So the other girl was asking, who is she? And my friend was also asking, who is she? So he was like, hey, stop. I want to talk. Then he was like, okay. Now he was talking to the other girl, who is not the fiancé. Like, listen, this is my fiancé. Her name is this. We have been together for 4 years and I am planning to marry her. I love her so much from my heart. I am very, very, very sorry to hurt you. I am very sorry to lie to you, but this is the girl that I love. I am very sorry to break your heart. He was talking to the other girl. Oh my God. You know what? Even my friend started feeling sorry for the other girl, because the other girl was really in love. And she was sure that the man really loved her. So this man was like, no. I am sorry. Then he turned to the fiancé and said, my fiancé, I am very sorry. Yes, I made a mistake. Yes, I am a cheater. Yes, call me all names. But I promise, I won't repeat again. Please forgive me. Guys, if you were the fiancé, what could you have done? please, I want you to tell me in the comments below, what could you have done in such a situation? But for my friend, she forgave him, guys. She forgave him, and the other girl went, and the relationship ended. The fiancé married my friend, and they continued their life. But what I am not sure of, because later on I resigned, and also she resigned, I heard, and went to the other place, so we lost communication. But I don't know what continued, if that man stopped or later on continued his behavior. I don't know, guys, because for me, if it was me in that situation, guys, forgiveness, no, not at all. Because you imagine, if my friend didn't find out, what could have happened? I think he could have continued his game. And who knows, he has another. Or who knows, in future, he will start a game. So for me, it could have been a no. For me, it could have been a no, guys, a no. So guys, that was it. Thank you so much for watching this video till now. I really hope you enjoyed this story so much. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also, comment what you think about this video. Don't forget to share with your friends, your family, everyone that you think will enjoy this story. Please, I have other videos too that I did in the past. Help me to watch them. They are so good. You're going to learn a lot. Subscribe, please. You are always here. I love you so much. Ciao, ciao.